The Google Pixel 2 and Pixel 2 XL are two of the best Android phones of the year. They're certainly not the flashiest, but they do everything they try to so well. And there isn't actually that much difference between them. The biggest differentiator is the design and display, but the camera performance and software are all exactly the same. The Pixel 2 XL goes for the near bezel-less front, while the smaller one has a huge bezel running around the screen. Google has also covered the aluminium body in a textured coating, which adds some much needed grip. Both phones are IP67 rated for water resistance, but you'll also have to use the included dongle if you want to connect headphones. That's annoying, but it's becoming more common and will only get more so. High-end Android phones have always been quick, but the original Pixel felt super fast. The Pixel 2 and Pixel 2 XL don't quite have the huge performance shift of their predecessor, probably because it uses the same Snapdragon 835 and 4GB of RAM as the majority of 2017 flagships. Nevertheless, it remains speedy in almost every single area. The basic model includes 64GB of storage, but there's a 128GB version available too. There's no microSD expansion though, so choose your choice wisely. The Android Oreo software experience here is so much cleaner, so much smoother, and so much easier to use than any other Android skin that's come before. I can forgive the lack of an HDR display or microSD slot simply because it's such a pleasure to use an Android phone that isn't brimming with bloatware and superfluous extras. Google has been tinkering with the home screen for years now, and I think the launch on the Pixel 2 is the best it's ever been. The Google search bar has been moved to sit below the icons, meaning you don't need to reach up to interact with it, and a new dynamic weather and calendar widget changes depending on your upcoming appointments. There's also a selection of incredibly cool wallpapers that subtly change throughout the day. A couple of other new software additions include Google Lens and Active Edge. Stripped straight from the HTC U11, the sides of the Pixel 2 are pressure sensitive. Grip the phone, squeeze, and the assistant will pop up. Google Lens is clever too. This will scan contents of your pictures and throw out relevant Google search results. At 6 inches, the screen on the Pixel 2 XL is the biggest seen on a Google-branded handset since the Nexus 6. The display on that phone was one of its weaker features, and it's a similar story here. It isn't bad, but it simply isn't in the same league as the panels manufactured by Samsung and used in its own flagships. Instead of using one of those fantastic Super AMOLED displays, Google has instead opted for a plastic OLED or POLED from LG. LG isn't as experienced as Samsung when it comes to building smartphone displays, and it really shows. In terms of colours, the screen lacks punch and whites are often tinged with blue. If you're looking at a website that's primarily white, the colour isn't uniform and is frequently streaked with grey. It's also a very cool display, meaning you'll feel it in your eyes when you've been staring at it for long periods. It isn't all bad news, however. With the Quad HD Plus resolution, there's plenty of detail and movies look great. Things are much better with the screen on the smaller Pixel 2. It's a 5-inch 1080p AMOLED and the colours are much better. The single biggest reason to choose the Pixel 2 or Pixel 2 XL over any other handset is the camera. On paper, the 12-megapixel f1.8 unit sounds fairly pedestrian. In use, however, it captures some wonderfully detailed images. They're often much better than those produced by the competition. A great camera shouldn't really be a surprise. The original Pixel is still one of the best around. However, the range of improvements Google has added take it to the next level. These include optically stabilizing the lens for less shaky shots, widening the aperture to let more light into the sensor, and improving the processing that goes on after you've pressed the shutter button. Pictures from the Pixel 2 aren't like those from a Samsung Galaxy S8 or iPhone 8. They're less saturated with deep colors and look far more lifelike. I do love the rich hues of images captured on a Samsung phone, but they're unmistakably from a phone camera. Shots taken with the Pixel 2 transcend this and look so much better for it. Colours are vibrant, but greens don't have that fluorescent glow, and it doesn't make flowers look artificial. Where the Pixel 2's camera really shines is in the level of detail crammed into each shot. Everything from pollen inside a flower to writing on a sign in the distance makes the frame, and you can even crop in on the picture without turning it into a blurry mess. Clearly, many of these tricks are a result of Google's excellent software and optimizations. The Auto HDR Plus mode is on by default. You'll need to bury down in settings to actually turn it off. And Google is confident its processing tricks are the way forward. And on seeing the results, it's really hard to argue. Shots taken in this mode have some of the best dynamic range I've ever seen on a phone. Low light photos are bright, have good exposure, and still manage to capture subtle colors and shadows. Even though both pixels forgo the now common dual sensor setup, Google continues to include a portrait mode for blurring the background and keeping the subject in sharp focus. This works on both the rear and front-facing 8-megapixel cameras, producing surprisingly good results. Even though the batteries are different on the two phones, I've had similar results on both. They'll get you through the day, but not much more than that, and they both charge super quickly. Unless you really want a small phone, I'd say plump for the Pixel 2 XL. You get that bigger display and slimmer bezel, and it's always better having more screen to play with. But both of these are excellent devices and strong competition for every other Android phone.